undergraduate PhD student at University of Hawaii at Manoa. So my research topic is microaeration for controlling volatile fatty acid accumulation in high loading rate anaerobic digestion processes. Anaerobic digestion process is the digestion process that digests organic matter and produce energy. So you can think it as our digestive system. So we ingest the food to have energy for our daily activity. So same thing, we put anything organically degradable into the system and then we will produce energy. So the energy is in form of biogas. So this gas will burn to create heat, power, electricity, or can use as fuel. So in this case, this is two of my reactor, and then I feed grass into my reactor. So this is vegetarian. But you can feed anything like from food waste or waste sludge or anything organically degradable. And then it will produce biogas. So here, I collect the gas in this bag. From this bag, I will demonstrate how it can create energy. So I will take the biogas in this bag. And then this one is good for burning for fuel. So you can see that this system can produce energy from virtually anything organic. But they have one problem. You see that it's same our digestive system. So when you eat too much, for example, you know, like when in Thanksgiving or when you have a buffet, you have a lot to eat, more than you can handle, you will feel uncomfortable in your stomach. And then you feel some kind of burning sensation. So it is because of your acid in your stomach accumulate. So sometimes it have the reflux of acid that make you feel uncomfortable. So what you do? So first thing, you stop eating. And second, you have to ingest some kind of medicine. You can see that all the drugstore, they have the section called antacid. So basically it is alkaline that neutralize the pH accumulating in your stomach when you're eating too much. Same thing happened in my system. When I put too much food in, it's starting accumulating the acid and cause the drop in the performance. There are no biogas production because there are too much volatile fatty acid accumulation in my system when I feed too much.
Again, you can see in this illustration, anaerobic digester can digest complex organic matter into the soluble organic matter and then start the fermentation to create volatile fatty acid, which serve as substrate for producing methane or biogas. However, when there are too much VFA accumulation, there are no biogas production and no energy created. And in the severe case, it might require the restarting of the digester, which cause huge economic loss for the biogas plant.
So normally when we add too much food in the system and then the volatile fatty acid start accumulating, what we have to do? Normally we will stop eating and then add some chemical to neutralize the acid to bring up the pH and then wait until the system stable and then you can eat again to produce energy. So same thing with when we feel acid reflux in our system, we stop eating and then we take some medicine to neutralize the acid. However, for the economical reason, we want to design a process control system that can allow the system keep eating but still running stable and then no volatile fatty acid accumulation. Just imagine, we think about the way that allow you to continuously eating all the time, and you have so much energy and never feel bad in your stomach. So that is the system we want, a super system that can eat a lot, very stable, and then generate a lot of biogas for our fuel. So this digestive system is anaerobic. That means no air. So no air to create a condition so some kind of microorganism can eat the food and then creating biogas for our fuel. However, these microorganisms, they eat very slowly and they are very sensitive. There are some change in the environmental condition and then it stop eating. So it cause the accumulate in the volatile fatty acid as we talk about. But the aerobic bacteria, they can eat up this organic acid very quickly when they have oxygen. So we found a way to give the aerobic bacteria, the one that use oxygen, enough oxygen to eat up this organic acid when it accumulating in the system. But just give small enough so it will not harm the bacteria that don't like oxygen. We call this process microaeration, which is the process that just give just enough amount of oxygen so we can maintain both aerobic and anaerobic microorganism. So we use a very simple electrode called the ORP, the oxidation reduction potential electrode. So this electrode is super cheap, very robust, and is very sensitive to oxygen. So we can use this to control the dosing of oxygen when we want. So when the ORP level go down to certain level, indicating the oxygen is very low, we will start injecting just a little bit of oxygen and then it go up and wait until the aerobic bacteria using up the oxygen and then it go down again until the under limit of oxygen and then we start injecting the oxygen again. So when there are too much oxygen left in the system, it will automatically stop the injection and it just inject oxygen when the oxygen go down to certain level and then it spike up just a little bit of oxygen, just enough for the aerobic microorganism to use. So by doing so, we create a perfect condition that allow both type of microorganism to live in central free to digest the food even at high loading rate, and it's very stable for the whole process, and then we have a lot of biogas production even at high loading rate, and they never have the accumulation of the organic acid. So now we go deep into the molecular level to explain what happened in the system when we put the oxygen, how the pathway changed, what kind of bacteria appear more, and how the microbial community structure they change. We want to see how much energy they can create and how they work together as a community to support each other to digest all the food we put in. And this research has a huge potential for application. By adapting this system, the current AD plant can run at a very high loading rate with very stable condition, very stable performance, and continuously producing biogas for electricity, fuel, and heating.